water.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
So, for this Christmas, I'm going to give you something very special, and I'm going to be answering a question that I find a lot, and in fact, in the future, we may be making a course about this. Basically, the question is, how to love yourself first. Now, if you've been following me on social media, if you go to Get Him Hooks or at Get Him Hooks or gethimhooked.com or whatever, you will have heard me say this quite a lot. And the simple thing is, you know you love yourself when you don't have to ask that question. Now, that might be very simple. That might be a very simple thing, but you know, well, let's talk about the situation, why people ask that question. So people ask that question like, how do I love myself first? I just need to love myself first. When they're in a situation, when they're struggling to make something happen, it might be with a potential romantic partner, or it might be just in life, or it might be, you know, in a workplace or a particular job or whatever. And you know, you see people who are charismatic, you see people who are charming, and you see people who just seem to know themselves or to love themselves, get what they want to get. Now, this isn't that you aren't enough for love. This isn't that you aren't enough as a human being. This isn't that you just aren't. It's just that sometimes we're trained to ask that question. We are trained by life, we are trained by society, we are trained by this thing to ask ourselves, if we didn't get the position, if we didn't find love, if we didn't achieve what we wanted to achieve, then there was something wrong with us. And when we're in that situation, that's when we start to look outwards, when we should start looking inwards. So we look outwards for things like advice. We look outwards for information. We look outwards for fashion sense. We look outwards for sex, drugs, alcohol, whatever, to make ourselves feel better. Now, this is where where I often say that loving yourself first can actually be like a little bit of a drug. Because if it's anything like a lot of dating advice, a lot of people can get sucked into it a lot, where they spend their life chasing advice, or they spend their life seeking a mentor or seeking a person to help them through their situation. And often that can be really detrimental because you're training in yourself that it's not okay to be you. And here's the fucking truth. If you want to love yourself first, if you want to be in this situation where you don't have to ask that question if you are enough, all you need to do is notice if you are asking that question. Because the moment you notice it, if that thought is like a train, if that self-depreciating thought is like, but I'm not good enough, but I didn't love myself enough, what's wrong with me, is like a train that keeps going. When you notice that that is what you are thinking, it will slow the train down. Now, if this won't be an overnight thing, this will be a thing that might last 6 months, might last a year, whatever. But it will last as long as it needs to last because everyone's conditioned in certain ways. This took me years to overcome. I kept looking for so many other people for advice and so many things, and it was like I was chasing a drug of validation. And the irony is, now you're looking to me for advice, right? Or you're watching a video like this, but I'm here to show you that you have the power within yourself, that maybe there are some fun, cool little techniques and flirty stuff and stuff that you can learn. But a good majority of the time, you have the power already. It's within you. You just don't know it. You aren't aware of it. Or if you are aware of it, you're growing your awareness to it. It's like you're asleep, or you think you're asleep and you're trying to wake up, but you've always been awake and you've never noticed that. So the simple answer is to start to notice if you are thinking about these kinds of things. But second of all, is to stop asking that question. To say, how will I be good enough? Why am I not good enough? Why didn't they like me? You know, when will I love myself first? Why don't I love myself enough? Why am I not enough? All of these questions are questions. They are questions that train your mind to think in a certain way. And the moment you stop asking it is the moment it stops being a question that needs to be answered. I love the phrase, beggars can't be choosers. Because people say that, well, you're a beggar, you can't be a chooser. But similarly, choosers aren't beggars. So stop begging, and that's where choosing starts. And it might take longer, but the results you get are so much more phenomenal. The people you connect with are so much more deeper, richer. The emotions, the intimacy, the love, the connection that you have comes from a place that is unparalleled. but it's not about validation. Because people start off, and I'm getting into a rant now, and I don't care, I'll leave this in. Because normally I like to do one topic or whatever, but I'm gonna fucking leave this in. The thing is, most people start out trying to figure out how to get the world to bend to them. So they learn techniques, they learn advice, they go to YouTube, they all this shit, right? And so when they do this, the second thing that they learn then is that they start to do it for themselves. So they start, you know, they might learn, oh, how to be more attractive. So they start to wear more clothing. And then the second is the pursuit of loving yourself, the pursuit of feeling okay with yourself tends to be around doing it for yourself. So you might learn fashion to make other people like you, right? Then the second thing is fashion to make yourself feel good because you're like, I can wear whatever I want, I'm worthy, things like that. That itself is still playing this emotional rat race because you're trying to make yourself feel good, and that's good to feel good, but the pursuit of feeling good makes it a dichotomy. The moment you are trying to make yourself feel good is the moment that you are separate from it. It is like the phrase, to be in love. When you say you are in love, that is to assume you can be out of it, and you are an example of it. So the thing is, then the third stage that most people go through is realizing that they can step out of it, that clothing, feeling good. So they can step out of it, like clothing, feeling good, love, intimacy, all this stuff is not about you. It is not about someone else. It is about the exchange of energy. It's about making everyone feel better, making the world change, heal, grow, love deeper. And therefore, it stops being a tool that you use to make yourself feel better or get other attention. All of these things that you might do. People chase yoga, for example. People chase online courses. People chase, like, Christmas. Everything can be used as a drug or something that is beneficial for everyone. And the third stage is stepping out of that and realizing that you can use these things for the benefit of everyone. If you want to learn how to love yourself first, help someone else learn how to love themselves. Also, make sure to leave a like, because if you did, then I like you. And make sure to subscribe, because if you don't, Santa won't come this year. I won twice.